this second language that we call faith. She recognized in the mysterious voice of the angel, she recognized and possessed this hidden language, this capacity to recognize mystery, to sense a deeper reality. She knew what it was like to hear an inner voice, a nonverbal invitation, an intrusion into her spirit that was both exhilarating and distressing at the same time. We'll never really know exactly what Mary experienced, but we do know that she understood the invitation of God, and she said, yes. Actually, my favorite aspect of the Annunciation story is the sense of being troubled. The scripture today uses the word troubled. I like the New American Translation better. It says, deeply disturbed. I think she was disturbed by this. You know, trouble you can kind of deal with. Disturbance is deeper. She had to be frightened. She had to be caught off guard and upset. By what mysterious, what was surely a deeply distressing and mysterious experience. And the dynamic here is so wonderful. She knows this mystical experience is real. And she asks the question, how can this be? She's not placid about engaging this angel. Faith told her to ask the question, how can this be? And the angel respected her enough to respond, God will do it. Nothing is impossible with God. Faith gives us what we need to ask the disturbing questions, to discern even the most mysterious and surprising turns of the road, the unexpected invitations we are given to live a deeper, fuller gospel life. The language of faith puts words on this mysterious feeling, this unnamed desire, this deeply felt conviction that defies logic. Most especially in our day, when so much is evolving, when I am sure you have had moments when nothing seems to make sense, or maybe not. The mystery of God is so evident, and knowing the language of faith could not be more urgent. Having the capacity and the courage to ask the disturbing question could not be more necessary. Lucy and Carmen have heard this invitation, the mysterious voice of discernment that called them to this path as a Dominican sister of Adrian. And giving their own experience of all of you and all of you of them, I cannot be surprised in many ways. It does not surprise me, it makes perfect sense. Even in the context of the communal discernment of the Dominican Sisters of St. Catherine de' Ricci to merge with the Dominican Sisters of Peace. This call, this invitation that Lucy and Carmen have responded to with courage makes sense. And we, your Dominican Sisters of St. Catherine de' Ricci, bless it. We love you. And we wish you every good thing. Sandra Snyders has said, the most fundamental act of obedience is agreeing to live in our own time. And like it or not, this is our own time, now, today. This journey that Lucy and Carmen have been on to discern their place in the Dominican family is like a kind of Dominican itinerancy that asks that we know where our hearts lie, and moves us to relocate our hearts to the place that needs them most. Itinerancy in our tradition is a kind of relocation of the heart, of reprioritization of our lives that requires careful disturbed by what we hear. And it requires that all of us listen for faith, listen for mystery, and not be afraid to ask questions. Faith in our capacity to understand its language makes the relocation, makes the itinerancy possible. Knowing the language of faith and asking the compelling question makes new exploration possible. Knowing the language of faith allows us to set on the unexpected road and gives us the courage to explore the possibilities and say yes to the unknown. Adrian Dominicans, you have had the courage to explore possibilities with Lucy and Carmen and to ask the disturbing questions. Faith gives all of us the capacity to live an obedient life. T.S. Eliot said, "If we shall not cease from exploration, and the end of all of our exploring will be to arrive where we started and know the place for the first time." Lucy and Carmen, you know this place. I hope you never cease from exploration. And may Mary's faith and capacity for courage give you what you need for the journey ahead. You remain our sisters. Dominican Sisters of Adrian, receive and love these women whom we have loved. Love them as we have loved them. For all of us are sisters to one another.